Hello everybody, my name is Adeife David and I would like to share with you a book which has been blessing me for a very very long time, titled A Beautiful Art, A Beautiful Life by Reverend Olufola Akeleke. Now, chapter 1 of this book is talking about what a beautiful art is. Everybody has a heart, but is yours beautiful? And you can never have a beautiful art if you don't possess the fruit of the Spirit, which can be found in the book of Galatians 5:22-23. Now, going to this chapter 2 of this book, it talks about knowing how healthy your heart is. Is your heart healthy? Everybody has a heart, but it takes so many things for your heart to be healthy. Now, the following point I want to consider if your heart is healthy or not. The first thing is your thought, what you think in your mind. The second thing is the type of friend you keep. And the third thing is what takes your time. Now let's move on a little bit further, going to the chapter 3. It talks about the types of art, knowing which art is yours. Having a good art is your choice. And looking at it, we have different types of art. Number one art we have is the roadside art. We have the rocky art, we have the turning art, and we have a good or a beautiful art. Which do you choose this moment? Now let's go to the chapter 4 of the same book, which talks about the process of the heart, processing your heart, which can be found in the book of Jeremiah 4:14. And it says, O Jerusalem, watch thy heart from wickedness, that thou mayest be saved. How long shall thy thought lodge within thee? Now let's move further to chapter 5, talking about maintaining your heart. As individuals, as believers, we need to maintain our heart, and we can go to the Bible to look for Matthew 7:6. Now, ways to maintain your heart. Number one, fellowship. Number two, evangelism, which is key. In making the kingdom of God, we need to evangelize, we need to actually reach out to souls. Number three is studying the word of God, Bible study. And the fourth one, praying in the Spirit. Now, going further to chapter 6. Everybody goes to work every day. And our heart even needs to work. We need to work our heart as believers. And we can look into that in John 1:1. And also we can going further to chapter 7, which says overcoming negative emotions. Everybody undergoes issues, trials, tribulations, temptations, and with a good and a beautiful heart, we can overcome negative emotions. Chapter 8 talks in the same book talks about anger management. I get angry easily, but reading this book has actually helped me a lot to actually overcome my anger. And looking at Proverbs 22:24, make no friendship with an angry man, and with a furious man thou shalt not go. So we need to, this book will actually teach us on how to manage our anger. In chapter 9 it talks about you can be whole. You can be whole. God can make you whole when you commit to his word and turn away from iniquity, which is, we can look into Isaiah 60:1. Now let's go to the chapter 10 of the same book. It talks about the issues of life. You know the Bible is speaking in the book of Proverbs 4:23 that keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it flows the issues of life. So we need to guide our heart constantly from every worldly cravings. And this same book in the chapter 11 of this book talks about the heart man and the head man. Now, I want us to consider one thing. The heart is one thing and the head is one thing. The head consists of our mind, all. Now, is your faith in your heart or is it in your mind? So many things flow through our mind. So if your faith is in your mind, you can actually go and go. Or it has to be in your heart. Now let's go forward. Don't let me take your time. Chapter 12 of this same book talks about the love of your heart. Your money, your heart, and God. Your money, your heart, and God. And you can look into John 3:28 and Deuteronomy 8:18 just to shed more light on it. Now let's look at chapter 13, which talks about the dashboard of the heart. The Bible speaking, it says, for where the treasure of a man is, that's where his heart will be. Now, where is your treasure? Is it in God? Or is it in the world? Let's look at chapter 14. It talks about the greatest gift of the heart. The number one greatest gift of the heart of life and everything is your heart, your praise, your worship, your service, and the last one, which is forgiveness. And let's look at chapter 15, which talks about no more heartbreak. No more heartbreak. It's talking about when you are actually renewed and in Christ. When you are not conformed or transformed by the renewal of your mind, that ye may prove what is good. When you are in Christ, there will never be heartbreak. And the Bible is speaking in Psalms 82 verse 6 that I have said, ye are God and all children of the Most High. That is when you are already a child of God. Excuse me, how will that be come to you? So, I would actually want to get this book by A Beautiful Heart, A Beautiful Life by Reverend Odufola Akeke. It has actually transformed my life and turned things around for me. And I hope it's good for you. I'm very, very sure it's good for you. God bless you.